It's hard to avoid the hype around AI these days, but you might be wondering, why? Why the hype? What's it all about? As a member of IBM's client engineering team, we help our customers understand where new technology can deliver value for their business. And honestly, that's what it comes down to with AI. It delivers value, it creates value. When we help our customers select projects, we help them decide on two axes. The first is feasibility. If feasibility is high, that means it is easy to do. And if it's low, that means it's hard. So when we have these discussions with our clients, they might list out several options, things they might want to explore. As we decide what to start with, what we want to do, the technical people, both on the IBM side and with the client, they'll sit down together and discuss how hard, how easy is this to do, and they'll kind of rank those things. The other thing that we want to look at is value. How much value does it deliver to the business? Is it low or is it high? And then we draw some curves here. Now, if it's up here, if feasibility is high, if it's really easy and it delivers a lot of value, well, that has this complicated name. It is a no-brainer. Now, if it's easy to do, doesn't deliver a lot of value, but does deliver some value, we call that low-hanging fruit. Now, if it's doesn't deliver a lot of value and it's hard to do, we might put that in our backlog, right? We might get to that someday. And if it delivers a lot of value and it's really hard, we're going to call that a big bet. May not pan out, but it does deliver a lot of value. If you want to know what AI is all about, you can stop listening right now. It's all about value. So feasibility is pretty straightforward to work through, right? Engineers can usually figure out how long it's going to take, how many people are going to have to work on it. Value can be tricky, right? Let's say you're a company who has a lot of contracts and service agreements, you've got statements of work, you've got a lot of numbers in there for different services offered, and you'd like to look through this whole body of contracts and find out who your lowest cost vendor is for a particular service. That's pretty close to an impossible task, right? Especially in a reasonable amount of time. You might look at AI solving that problem as being incredibly valuable to your company. But let me ask you a question. How many people are finding those answers for your company right now? If it's two, I hate to shock you, that might be impossible, but it doesn't have high value. It's only two people. So the most that value could be is their the salary of these two people. So let me help you think through some ways to help really quantify what that value is. The first thing we'll look at, and I've already talked about this, is people. And we can also phrase this maybe as operational efficiency. Okay? The next thing that we want to think about is risk. And then the third thing, and this one really is a no-brainer, is does it generate new revenue or does it help avoid cost? Okay, so let's go back to people. So there's two things really you want to think about when you're thinking about people. The first thing you want to think about is the number of people involved. The second thing you want to think about is the percentage of their time that they spend on these things. So there's a little more math. You kind of have to figure out kind of what the average salary of that group may be, but and I'll put that down here as a number three. So what is the cost per person? You have these three things: how many people, what percentage of their time they use, and how much your average cost per person is. You can get a very finite number, right? We look back at that example. If you have 100 people working that problem, that would justify spending a lot of money for AI to solve that problem. If you have two people solving that, it may be completely impossible for those two people to do, but the value that the company has placed on that is the value of those two people. Okay, next, want to talk about risk. Risk is hard to quantify, right? Especially the business and technical people who might be in a meeting, they don't have a good feel for how much a lawsuit could cost or how much having a catastrophic failure might cost in terms of lost revenue. But what you can do is you can identify the types of risks that you're looking at. You can identify the magnitude for each of those things, right? And then you can also look at what's the chance of each of those things happening. And that can at least provide some direction of what might happen. Now, there's a third category, and I'm going to call that time risk or future risk, right? And what all I'm saying here is that investing in technology in general helps to future-proof your company. Now, the final one is revenue, and this is fairly straightforward. I do want to call out something, though. Do not double count. If you've already accounted for people up here, you can't count it again down here in terms of cost saved. But if there are other operational efficiencies, you definitely want to count that. The other thing I want to highlight is there new revenue? Are there new ways that you can save cost, right? For example, you have these contracts. Like, I'll go back to the same example. You have a lot of contracts that you have to look through to find costs. Let's say that you need to find answers in these contracts in order to formulate a response for an RFP. Well, if you get a request for an RFP that's due tomorrow, you probably can't look through those 10,000 contracts and provide an answer in a timely manner. So that's just a lost opportunity, right? Sometimes the total contract cost or a contract value of an RFP might not be high enough that it's worth having the people in your company go look through those contracts. It's not going to pay itself off for the time they're going to spend. Both of those are good examples of a place where you're currently leaving money on the table because it's just not worth it, and now it would be. So when you're thinking about AI, it really delivers value for companies in three areas. People can save them time and effort. It can reduce risk, and it can drive new revenue opportunities, or it can reduce cost. So that's all the hype about AI. It's enabling business to generate more value than ever before. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe.